Hey everybody, so it's July 23rd, 2023, and we were about 4 hours from a strike with Yellow Corporation happening, and they just got a little bit of a reprieve. It's a very short reprieve, so let's see what happened. So tonight I'm just hanging out back here. Out in my backyard. It's a beautiful night here in Pennsylvania, and weather's about perfect. So I was hanging out back here with the computer, maybe having one or 10 beverages. And I decided to check up on the Yellow Freight thing, I still call it Yellow Freight, it's the Yellow Corporation. But I decided to check up on it. And it looks like they got about a 30-day extension. And this was done by their insurance company. So I set this camera down here. We'll do some reading through because didn't do a lot of prep for this video. I wanted to try to drop the video as soon as possible so people could see what's going on, since we've been talking about Yellow so much and you know, the potential, its fate. First, let's talk about the reason for this strike, why it was about to happen. Now, we know that Yellow is failing miserably, and we know that Yellow is suing the Teamsters right now. For reasons that I don't quite understand. I guess they want the Teamsters to bail them out again, because that's how they survive, is on bailouts, and that's how they survived for a long time. But here was the reason for the strike. I'll read this right from the screen, because I wanted to see what was sparking this exactly, so I had it right. And so the driver's going to go on strike as of tomorrow, and this is a direct line out of this article that was on NACS, Advanced Convenience and Fuel Retailing. I found this and it was just hilarious. It says, coming up on a $1.2 billion loan next year and continued loss of revenue for the last few months, Yellow's trying to maintain its liquidity and avoid bankruptcy by withholding its employees' health and pension benefits. I'm sorry, I had to take a sip of a drink. According to the Wall Street Journal, Nashville, Tennessee-based Yellow is the third largest operator in less-than-truckload business, in which carriers haul cargo from multiple customers in the same trailer, the Journal reports. Most people that watch me know what LTL is, but so in response, the Teamsters Union is threatening a strike as soon as July 24th, which would have been tomorrow, if payments are not received by the end of the week. Obviously, the Teamsters are going to strike. When you have a company, you're trying to make more money. So the logical thing to do is to stop paying your employees' health and pension benefits. Because nobody will be mad about that. They'll just be happy that they're still working. Yeah, yeah. That is not legit at all. I am not a Teamster. I don't work for a union, and there's no way I could put up with this. I wouldn't have lasted, I probably wouldn't have lasted 6 months putting up with this. And really, I feel so bad for, you know, my fellow, you know, brother and sister drivers that are dealing with this right now, because I just can't imagine the anxiety and the pain that you guys are going through, once again, having to, you know, have put your heart and soul into these companies, and now you're dealing with this again. But it goes on, the board of trustees that managed benefits for a Teamster stated Yellow withheld payments due July 15th and indicated it would do the same for the August 15th payments. Makes sense. You know, like, hey, I don't have money right now, so I'm just going to withhold some mortgage payments. And, you know, the two missed payments would total $50 million. It does go on here. There's an analyst, TD Cowen analyst, said that we believe it would be extremely difficult for Yellow to recover from a full-blown strike given its precarious financial status. In my other videos, I've talked about all the other money they're on the hook for. But, again, just... where does this mentality come from? We need to make more money, so let's just totally screw our employees out of anything, and maybe they'll work harder for us. I don't get it. So let's go on to how they averted the strike and why it's a very temporary thing. So this article I switched up came out a couple hours ago. It did just come out this evening, and this is actually a couple outlets did a few different articles, but this is actually from the International Brother of Teamsters. So what happened was they were actually going to lose their health insurance, and so the Central States Health and Welfare Fund agreed Sunday to extend health care benefits for workers at Yellow Corp operating companies. YRC Freight in Holland, under intense pressure from Teamsters General President Sean M. O'Brien and General Secretary Treasurer Fred Zuckerman. The extension of health care benefits for Teamsters and their families averts a strike at the freight companies, which could have begun on Monday or tomorrow after Yellow failed to make contractually obligated benefits payments of $50 million to Central States on July 15th. The agreement by Central States at the urging of the Teamsters gives Yellow's 30 days to pay its bills, with the understanding that the company will do so within the next 2 weeks. It does go on to discuss the intense discussions. And I have said before, I understand what a union is, what the Teamsters are. Actually, my brother's a Teamster, a very happy one. He doesn't work for Yellow because he's pretty happy. But now I kind of understand this. You know, the Yellow Freight is suing, or Yellow Corp is suing the Teamsters because they want a bailout. They want to keep this going, and they want the Teamsters to bail them out, and the Teamsters aren't doing it. But the Teamster did not just throw up their hands and say, we're done with this. No, they're still, I guess, you know, the union is about the drivers or so. Different people would have different opinions, but this is what I'm seeing from this, is that they actually did work tirelessly to at least avert a strike temporarily, you know, to make sure. And it does go on here to say, you know, our drivers can't work without health insurance. Look, all right, I mean, I'm an owner-operator, but I do have health insurance. My wife works a pretty good job. But, you know, when you think about this, you think, all right, yeah, you could avoid that doctor's appointment or maybe buy some prescriptions out of your pocket. You're talking about a whole lot of drivers here. Some of these drivers are going through chemo. Some of these guys are in the hospital. It's a percentage thing. You just know. I mean, there's a lot of things that affect a lot of people. Some of these guys, they've had benefits for wives or husbands or and, you know, what if they just, let's say somebody's going through intense chemo treatment, and that's a horrible thing to do. Plus, you know, there's lots of other health things, but let's say they're going through that and now they have to worry about their insurance getting canceled in the middle of this. My God. I mean, really, Yellow, just really. Good job, Teamsters, for stepping up and at least averting this for a little bit. And like I said before, I laughed a couple times in this video. Mainly that's at the mentality of these, I'm not going to call names, but it's at the mentality of them. It's not about the drivers. Again, I feel sorry that you guys are going through this. I will keep updated. I will keep following this, because this was a very, very temporary reprieve, and the money still isn't there to actually make the payment. So all they did was, you know, one of the world's largest organizations, the Teamsters, got it extended. So good for you guys. You keep watching. I'll come up for it as I can. You know, like I said, brothers and sisters in the business, you know, stay strong, and I hope, you know, I hope this all works out for everybody. So, hey, thanks for watching this video. Like and subscribe if you did like it, and I'll catch you on the next one.